friends, and welcome back. Can you believe it? It is week 7, lesson 7. And today we are going to still dive a little deeper into composition. This time we are going to talk about perspective. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Click that little bell so you can get notifications every time I post a new video, which these lessons are coming out weekly. So if you want your son or daughter to look really big and tough, say you're going to create a poster of them for their birthday, you want them to look like a superhero, you put them up high, whether that's standing on something or you get down really low, and you shoot the photo up at them. And that will make them look really big and awesome and powerful. Now, if you want someone to look really small, you shoot down at them. That's one of the biggest problems I see with people photographing their kids these days, is they're just standing in their normal stature, normal posture, taking a photo of their child. The most simple improvement you can make in your photo is to get down on eye level with them. Some photos I took recently for a maternity shoot. Now you can see the family here, they're actually walking uphill towards me. So my perspective is somewhere up here, eye level with mom and dad. Big brother here is actually looking pretty small, and a lot of that has to do with number one, I'm shooting down towards them. I'm at eye level with mom and dad here, so I'm looking down at him and he looks really small. Now, one of the ways to make him look bigger is to get in closer. Now we have this fun shot. So you can see not only am I now at eye level with big brother here, but mom and dad are still represented here. So it's still a maternity shot. And if you remember our other composition, your eye is drawn to the brightest part of the photo, which is back here. You have the line coming in from the path here. And then all the foliage around the background just kind of disappears. Now let's take this a step further. Now we've brought mom and dad down to big brother's level. And now I'm eye level with them here. So now he looks like a big brother, big boy. Now we see all of mom and dad. It's actually a nice compliment too, because you have the path coming in this way. You have the bright white at the end. You actually get lines here from mom and dad's legs pointing towards big brother. And you're looking at this photo more from the perspective of big brother, which is super fun. Now, let's take this a step further. My favorite way to shoot. Now, it's still a maternity shoot. We still have mom and we still have dad. But now we're focusing on big brother here. I am eye level with him. And I'm so close to him that the background is super blurry. This right here is just a pretty pop of color as an accent. And then you get the beautiful, nice sharp shot of the hands, mom and dad holding big brother's hands. You get baby right here. Just a super fun, beautiful picture. This is one of my favorites in something like a maternity shoot.
So your exercise for today is to go out and take photos of someone, take it from three angles, shooting up, shooting your cameras here, you shoot up towards your subject, you shoot at eye level with your subject, and you shoot down towards your subject. And I want you to evaluate each of those photos. If I could give you any advice while you're learning photography, is be willing to take the extra photo. If you wanted to learn how to paint, you might have to paint the same thing 3 or 4 or 5 times before you really started to like it and really started to understand how the different paint strokes improved your painting. It's the same thing for photography, but it's much easier because you can just continue taking photos and you waste nothing. Take your time, take the photo, evaluate it right there while you're taking the photo. Don't be in a rush. Look at the photo and say, okay, it's a little dark, make an adjustment. Or my perspective isn't quite right. The background looks kind of noisy. switch your angle, increase your aperture so that that background goes blurry. There are lots of little tweaks you can do that will drastically improve your photography. And if you haven't taken advantage of it yet, I have free printable guides for every single lesson that tells you exactly how to do the exercise. This will really help you to understand how these different steps will improve your photos. As usual, you guys, if you need help, please post the questions in the comments so I can get back to you and make sure that we don't miss anybody. Be sure to give me a thumbs up if you are enjoying these lessons. It helps me to know that I'm heading in the right direction. You can find me on Instagram at capture.create.explore. Be sure to use hashtag CCE workshop. Thanks, friends. Have a great day.